Let's keep going. So we talk about the membrane receptor, therefore peptide hormone and other lipophobic signals. And they usually trigger the second messenger system. And let's look at the membrane receptor. We have four different kinds of membrane receptor, their response. The first one is called the ligand-gated ion channel. This ion channel, we talk about the ion channel, their function is to make the ions go through the cell membrane. And these ion channels, most ion channels, they usually close. And ligand-gated ion channel, when the ligands, this is the chemical molecule, when they bind with it, they will open the ion channel. So if this is the sodium channel, when it opens, sodium can flow through it. And sodium is usually high outside, so it's going to flow into the cell. If this is a potassium channel, potassium is going to flow out because potassium is high inside, it's going to flow out. And some membrane receptor, then they can be the integrin. Integrin is, we don't emphasize too much of this one. This one is, it will connect with the cytoskeletal system. So it can change the structure, sometimes create movement of the cell when the ligands bind with it. And the third one is enzymes. So enzymes is very important in biology. In your intro bio, you learn a lot of enzymes function. They lower the energy required for the chemical process to be able to happen in a lower temperature. So your digestive system, you have a lot of digestive enzymes that are able to make the chemical process, which is digestion, to happen in your normal body temperature. And the last one, that's another important one, called G-protein coupled receptor. When these ligands comes, it binds with this receptor. So this receptor have several transmembrane area, and at UT we have professor, they spend their whole life study one kind of G-protein coupled receptor, and they'll be so happy to explain their structure and their siblings to you. So they have several transmembrane structure, transmembrane what they call domains, and they have one, this is the outside, this is inside, so this is outside the cell, this is inside the cell, this is cell membranes around here. So the outside have the binding site, and it will bind with the ligand will bind with the receptor. And the inside, they have a protein called G-protein, that's why it's called the G-protein coupled receptor. When the ligands bind with the receptor, the G-protein part will dissociate. It will go to activate the other proteins inside the cell. So it's like one talk to the second talk to the third. So that's the G-protein coupled receptor. And what happens is when the ligands come, it binds with the receptor side, the binding side is on the outside. Now it activates the G-protein. And the G-protein will go to activate the other protein inside the cell. So the other protein is called the second messenger. Like the first messenger is the ligands. And now the signal transferred through the G-protein, it transfer from the outside to the inside. It will activate the second messenger, the second guy, second big protein. And let's look at the second messenger. We have a lot of second messenger. And this process, the first messenger go to talk to the second messenger, go to talk to the third one. This process is called the signal transduction. Very important. It happens in a G-protein coupled receptor. And the second messenger, there are several second messenger systems, and they have different second messenger. Like if you like the spy movie, and you know, oh, James Bond. Yeah, okay. Every time you see James Bond, you know that's the spy movie, right? And that's the most famous one. But if you don't like James Bond, you may like Ethan Hunt. Okay, that's Mission Impossible. That's another spy. Okay, so there are several different kinds of second messenger. And the most famous one, cyclic AMP. So every time you see the cyclic AMP, it's like you see James Bond. You know, oh, this is my movie, okay? And every time you see cyclic AMP, you know, okay, that's the second messenger system. And you need to think back. Means these ligands, this chemical molecule, must be a lipophobic molecule. It will bind with a membrane receptor, and this membrane receptor is G-protein coupled receptor. And this G-protein coupled receptor activate cyclic AMP, and cyclic AMP will go to activate the other proteins inside the cell, like protein kinase A. That's your thinking logic. But you can have other second messenger. So you don't like James, you don't like James Bond. You like Ethan Hunt. Okay, you can cyclic GMP. When we talk about the sensory system, your rods and cones, these two photoreceptors on your retina, they actually use cyclic GMP. So they use different kind of second messenger. It still works. IP3, DAG, these are the second messenger system, and calcium. So when we talk about the muscle, we're going to talk about the muscle contraction, molecular mechanism of muscle contraction. We use the skeletal muscle to explain, but eventually we mainly focus on the cardiac muscle. We're going to talk about the cardiovascular system. And the signal, electrical signal, how they are able to transfer into the muscle contraction mechanical event, we call it EC coupling, electrical contraction coupling. And the key, the second messenger, is calcium. So it turned out the electrical signal, the action potential from the brain, you ask this muscle to contract, this signal gonna go through the muscle and gonna trigger the second messenger, that's the calcium release. So the calcium will bind with another protein called troponin. We're gonna learn it in the muscle contraction. And it's like the first bind with the second, talk to the third one. So it's called the signal transduction. Possible actions trigger release calcium, open close ion channels, modulate enzyme activity. So this is the possible response for the second messenger system. And this picture shows you what we just explained. If this ligand is lipophobic, it does not like lipid. It's lipophobic, so it could not go through the cell membrane. That's why you need to have a membrane receptor. And this membrane receptor is the G protein coupled receptor. When the ligand binds with it, the inside part, you have a G protein. And this G protein will go to talk to the second messenger. Could be the cyclic AMP, could be the IP3, could be the calcium. And these second messengers will trigger the other response inside the cell. So one talk to the second talk to the third. We call this signal transduction. And this is a video showing you the cyclic AMP, very important second messenger system. And you can watch this video, help you to understand the signal transduction. Okay, now let's switch gear to talk about homeostasis. Homeostasis is a stable environment inside the body. And last time we talked about osmolarity and tonicity. And I tell you, okay, your body, everything needs to be just right. Not too much, not too little. So water is important. And you learned if you don't drink water, this person will get sick or may die. And last time, you learned if you drink too much water too quickly, the water, the good stuff, can turn into a toxic called water intoxication, and the person can get sick or can have tenderness, muscle cramp, and the worst scenario is the person can die. We'll talk about it last time. And water, so your body concentration, osmolarity, is about 300 milliosm, and this is just one of them. All the others also want to maintain the stable environment. Not too much, not too little, just right. Like your body temperature is 98.7, 98, 99 Fahrenheit. And your heart rate, it's about 60 times per minute. And your blood sugar level and everything in your body need to be just right. And that's homeostasis. So let's look at homeostasis. To talk about homeostasis, we have to talk about this gentleman. He's Watson Cannon. He lived about 100 years ago. He's a Harvard professor in physiology. He's the father of physiology in America. 100 years ago, that's the time people struggle to find bread, bring it on the table, and in medical school, they learned what's the name of this muscle, what's the name of that blood vessel. And he started to talk about homeostasis, a stable environment. And homeostasis is very important. And not just talk about homeostasis, a stable environment. He actually predict your body must have this to maintain a stable environment. That's why he's the father of physiology in America. And after 100 years, we still found his prediction is correct. So let's see what he predicted. 100 years ago, he predicted your body must have a nervous system. Its job is to maintain homeostasis. And now we know that nervous system is called autonomic nervous system. And we will talk about this autonomic nervous system. It's not under your voluntary control. He has a tonic activity, so it constantly maintains your blood pressure, constantly maintain your heart rate, constantly maintain your osmolarity, constantly maintain your breathing rate, your body pH, your blood sugar level, your glomerular filtration rate in your kidney. So everything is maintained, tonic activity. And they have the antagonistic control. Antagonistic, this time, this means you have two. You have two. One increase, the other gonna decrease. That's how that's antagonistic means. And we know it's correct because you have this autonomic nervous system, you have the sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. When your sympathetic nervous system is activated, you can increase your heart rate. When your parasympathetic nervous system is activated, it will decrease your heart rate. So they're called antagonistic control. And how the receptor, how the target know is which one? Is the sympathetic, I'm supposed to increase the heart rate, or is parasympathetic, I'm supposed to decrease the heart rate? And the response depends on the chemical signal and based on the receptor. And this is why the sympathetic and parasympathetic, they use different receptors. So it's based on the receptor. And that's what the canon predict 100 years ago. And after 100 years, we still know it's correct. We still know it's correct. And that's why he's the father of physiology. And let's look at the circuitry to create homeostasis. You have a control center. And you need to have input signal. Say if you this time you want to control the blood pressure. Well, excuse me.